Namaste students, let us discuss some special entries from the chapter journal today. You have never come across such entries, so try and understand them very carefully. First is the concept of bad debts. See, the meaning of bad debts I have already explained to you when we did that chapter basic accounting terms. Bad debts means when any debtor refuses to make the payment. Debtors means the person to whom you sell the goods on credit. Now, when that person says that I don't have sufficient funds with me to make payment to you, so I can't make the payment, it means that that person has been declared as insolvent and he becomes bad debts because he did not make payment to us. So in this case, Ram, who owed rupees 10,000, is declared insolvent. Ram was debtor, was our debtor. He owed rupees 10,000 to us. Owed 10,000 to us means that Ram has to pay rupees 10,000 to the firm. Now is declared insolvent. Ram has been declared insolvent means that now he doesn't have sufficient funds to make payment to us. So he was declared as an insolvent. And 30 paisa in a rupee could be received. So he is only in a position to pay us 30 paisa in a rupee. It means that if we have to receive rupee 1 from Ram, then he can give only 30 paisa to us. Now in this case, Ram has to give us rupees 10,000. It means that he will be paying us 40% of the 10,000. Sorry, 30% of the 10,000. 30 paisa in a rupee means Ram is going to pay us 30% of the total amount. Had it been 40 paisa in a rupee, then Ram would have paid us 40% of this amount. Had it been 50 paisa in a rupee, Ram would have paid us 50% of the amount. But in this case, it is only 30 paisa. So Ram will give us 30% of this amount. It means total amount is 10,000. Ram can only pay us 30%. It means 3,000 only we'll be getting in form of cash from Ram. It means actual cash which will come in the business will be 3,000 out of 10,000. So the remaining amount, that is 7,000, becomes bad debts. Why am I debiting cash account here? Because cash is coming in the business. 7,000 we did not get from Ram, so he became in solvent or bad debt, so which is a loss for us, and all the losses to be debited. And who is going to make payment to us? Ram is going to make payment to us. Total amount is 10,000. Now in this case, next case, I hope that entry is clear to you. Now in this case, received 10,000 rupees from Ram, who was written off as bad debts in the previous year. So let us change the name, otherwise you will get confused. Let it be Rohan. Received rupees 10,000 from Rohan, who was written off as bad debts in the previous year. Now in this entry, what is basically happening, that a person was named Rohan. He was our debtor in the last year. He refused to make payment to us. So just like Ram, he also became bad debts in the last year. But in this year, what happened, that accidentally he paid some money to us. Like, though he was declared bad debts as last, like in the last year, but in the current year he paid rupees 10,000 to us. It means that Rohan, who was declared as bad debts, has now become bad debts recovered. I hope it's clear. Rohan was declared as bad debts in the last year. This year he paid rupees 10,000 to us. So he becomes bad debts recovered. So what entry are we going to pass? As cash will come into the business, write cash account debited 10,000. Fine. He was declared as bad debts in the previous year. So we can't use the word Rohan. Like in this case also, you check. Ram, otherwise Ram is a debtor, no? So it means Ram's account must be debited in our books. Now in this entry, if I am crediting Ram's account, it means that now the Ram's balance is zero in the books and now no Ram exists. Rather, we will call Ram by the name of bad debts. Fine, I repeat this point. point again. Ram was our debtor. He was having debit balance undoubtedly. But in this entry, we have credit, like we have credited his account. So now there is no Ram in our books. Rather, Ram will be named as bad debts. So now try to relate this concept in that entry also. Rohan was having debit balance in our books. Rohan has become bad debts. So we must have credited Rohan's account in the books last year. So now Rohan's balance is zero. So now in this case, if Rohan will make some payment to me, I can't use the word Rohan, because now I have to call Rohan by the name of bad debts. But now this bad debt means Rohan has given some money to us. It means that he becomes bad debts recovered, which is an income for us. So pass the entry, cash account debited to bad debts recovered 10,000. Or you keep it simple. If you can't understand this concept of debit and credit, no. See, these entries are little tricky and new also. So the concept will be set in your mind with the passage of time. Just don't assume that you will understand all the things in one go. Try to understand the entries and you may little learn them also. With the passage of time, the concept will be fit in your mind and then you can understand it very clearly. Got it? Now come to the next point now. That is outstanding expenses. Outstanding expenses, you know what are these? Means the expenses of the current year which we have not paid yet. Expense we have to pay in this financial year only, but we haven't paid it. So outstanding expenses becomes a liability for us, and all the liabilities are having credit balances. Fine. Now come to this transaction first of all. An employee is paid rent of rupees 1,000 per month, or let's say salary. An employee is there who is working in our business, and every month we are paying rupees 1,000 to him. It means if there are 12 months in a year, it means every year we are giving 12,000 to this person. But this financial year, what happens? That only 11 months salary have been given. But in this year, instead of giving 12 months or full year's salary, we gave him salary of rupees like only for 11 months. It means we must have paid 11,000 to him. We had to pay 12,000, but we have paid only 11,000. It means 1 month's salary, 1 month's salary of this financial year, we have not paid to this employee. So this 1 month's salary become outstanding. Because see, total 12 months generally we are paying, 12 months so generally we are paying in all the cases, no? So in this financial year we have paid only 11 months salary to him. It means 1 month's salary we have not paid. It's still outstanding. So that way we need to calculate it. 12,000 we are paying, 11,000 we have paid, only 1,000 is left. Means 1 month's salary which we have not paid. So see what's going to be the entry. Entry will be, you need to learn this entry because concepts will be stored in your mind with the passage of time. Fine. Entry will be salary account debited to outstanding salary account. 1,000. Because outstanding salary is only 1,000. So what is the entry? Salary debited to outstanding salary. We can't use the word salary to cash, because this 1,000 rupees has not been paid in cash yet. This 1,000 is outstanding. So we pass the entry salary to outstanding salary. Now come to this point. Salary due to clerks rupees 30,000. Again, due to clerks means, due means again outstanding. Means in this case also salary is outstanding. Means we have not paid salary of rupees 30,000 to clerks. So what entry are we going to pass? We pass the entry salary debited 30,000 to outstanding salary 30,000. I hope these three concepts are clear to you. Bad debts means the amount which we have not received from the debtors. Here, total 10,000 was given, like was owed by Ram to the firm. He could pay only rupees 3,000 to us in cash. So 3,000 is debited in cash account. 7,000 he could not pay us. So Ram becomes bad debts. So we have to debit bad debts account and we have to credit Ram's account. And crediting Ram's account means this balance has become zero in our books. Now Ram will not be named as Ram. Rather, Ram will be called as bad debts. Now suppose if now in the next entry, if any bad debts of the previous year give some money to us in the current year, then we have to pass the entry cash account debited to bad debts recovered. Bad debts recovered is our income, that's why it is credited, and bad debts is our loss, that's why it is debited. I hope these entries are clear to you. Now let's move to the next concept.